Welcome to the Archaeology Studio. In this installment of Ask an Archaeologist, the question is, how did you become an archaeologist? Like for most professions, archaeology requires years of training, education, and practice. These requirements have guided my career path. I should emphasize, though, that career paths are variable for everyone. At first, I admired museum exhibits and television documentaries about archaeology and about natural history, but I was unaware of how a regular person could gain the training and credentials for such a profession. Instead, I considered options of working as a videographer, as a writer, as a park ranger, as a carpenter, as a language translator, and as a farmer. Eventually, I found that aspects of all of those interests could be leveraged into archaeology. When I was partway through college, I learned that I could enroll in an archaeology course as part of a department of anthropology, and apparently such was the case throughout most of the United States. I was fortunate that teachers were patient with me and encouraging of my interests. Soon thereafter, I made a formal commitment in my education to concentrate in archaeology as part of my degrees in anthropology, continuing all the way through bachelor, master, and doctorate levels. In my case, I knew that I wanted to lead my own investigations, write books, and eventually teach about archaeology. For those purposes, I needed to earn a doctorate level degree. While I was pursuing my academic degrees, I was working whenever time allowed and whenever jobs were available. I happened to find reliable work in the private sector of cultural resource management or heritage management contracting. Eventually, I gained the practical skills and experience for performing all aspects of work in the private sector, and I advanced from an entry-level technician to a project director and a principal investigator. Meanwhile, my academic advisors in university contexts guided me through opportunities in a number of research projects, and they ensured that I was equipped to write research grant proposals and to produce publishable results that could withstand rigorous academic peer review. I continued to work in the private sector for many years, and therefore I gained extensive practical experience in diverse situations. By the time when I made a professional transition into academic work, I already had accumulated many years of successful projects, and I brought this experience into my new focus in teaching and writing. I cannot speak about the career histories of other archaeologists, but my case involved bringing various interests and skills into archaeology. In my view, this background made me aware of how to situate archaeology within the larger real world. Academic training and formal degrees are essential for professional work in archaeology, but they are incomplete on their own. For a successful career in archaeology, an academic education needs to be combined with real-life work experience. Toward this goal, many paths are possible, and the opportunities tend to be quite different from one location to another, and from one year to another. At least in my experience, a career in archaeology can move in different directions and require various skill sets. In this case, a more generalized background can be beneficial to succeed in the broadest range of circumstances that could develop. Do you want to see more videos about archaeology? I encourage you to explore the online archive of episodes and playlists in this YouTube channel. Please remember to subscribe to this channel and never miss another episode of the Archaeology Studio.